Hey there, we are back. It is January now. Last time I talked about the seasons, it was September and it was the equinox. We had 12 hours of day, 12 hours of nighttime. Now we have roughly 16 hours of darkness, 15 hours, let's say, and then let's say 9 hours of daylight. Okay, so depending on where you are in latitude, it's going to change. Those folks in Alaska, let's say north of the Arctic Circle, actually have 24 hours of darkness and lots of snow, very cold temperatures. It won't be until March 21st or thereabouts that it'll be the equinox again. So I wanted to talk about what causes the seasons. Now, first of all, it's not the distance. It is not the distance because right now we're actually closest to the sun. It's called the perihelion, and we are closest in January. We are farthest from the sun in July. That is called the aphelion. So there are two reasons for the seasons. One is that the Earth is tilted away at the moment from the sun, and the rays of the sun hit the Earth very obliquely, and it diffuses the light. And then in the summertime, the Earth is tilted toward the sun, and those rays are very direct. I've got a globe to show that, though. All right, so let's do right now. All right, the Earth is tilted away. Got a flashlight here. I don't know if that helps. And what's happening is that North America is tilted away from the sun. And you can see that right here. And so the rays hit very obliquely and it diffuses the energy of the sun. Okay, and then in the summertime, basically, this is 6 months later, we in the Northern Hemisphere are tilted toward the sun and the rays hit very directly here. Okay, that makes sense if you think about it. My favorite thing to do when I was a kid was to grab a magnifying glass, concentrate that energy into, let's say, a point, and you could burn something. So in the summertime, that energy is very concentrated because we're tilted toward the sun. One last thing real quickly here. The Earth is always pointed in the same direction. That's called polarity. Polaris, the North Star, is probably where that comes from. Sometimes it's called parallelism. So it's tilted toward the North Star. So check this out. So here's one part of the year. Here's the sun again. Let's do this parallel. Okay, last time. So I was talking about this being the winter solstice. Let's get North America around here. So we're tilted away, but watch this. 6 months later. Okay, now we are tilted toward North America. Turn it around. And let's do another 6 months. There we are, 6 months later. Turn the globe a little bit, and again, it's oblique. I think you get the idea. Review it. It is the tilt of the Earth, also known as the inclination, and also the fact that the Earth tilts in the same direction, known as polarity or parallelism. So that does it for our report in January.